It is now day 3 of Iceland's latest eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, its fifth such eruption to occur in a time span of only 6 months. In this short time span, an estimated 8.45 square kilometers or 3.26 square miles has been covered in a layer of lava, which I have estimated to contain a total volume of 38.3 million cubic meters of molten rock. This marks the ongoing eruption as the largest by total volume to occur since Vedur.is's famous 6-month-long eruption in 2021, which erupted 150 million cubic meters of basaltic lava. However, as you can see via this chart I made, lava during this eruption has covered more total land area than during any other Reykjanes Peninsula volcanic eruption in more than 650 years. While the rate of lava fusion dramatically dropped during the first 24 hours, in the 24 hours thereafter, it seems to have largely stabilized, albeit this rate is still slowly decreasing. I would estimate around 40 cubic meters to be actively erupting per second, a decrease of 20% in the last 24 hours. While forward progress of the lava flow has essentially stopped towards Grindavik, new areas are being covered in fresh lava as the thickness of near-vent areas continues to increase. Despite this, what I estimate to be around $6.39 million in damage has already occurred, with this total thankfully including zero structures and homes. Instead, this estimate is comprised of 13.2 kilometers or 8.2 miles worth of paved and dirt roads, which have been completely covered by and thus blocked off by erupted lava flows. 3 of the 6 roads into Grindavik have been completely blocked off, and even if this was not the case, access is still being restricted to Grindavik, so you cannot enter the town from any sector. While no obvious cracks have formed approximately a kilometer south-southwest of the Blue Lagoon, the ground in that area has subsided by up to 6 inches or 15 centimeters. This makes perfect sense as molten rock from this magma chamber was sent to the east and erupted, thus draining the chamber partially and causing ground overlying it to subside. On the various livestreams displaying purely effusive eruptive activity, you might have spotted a series of curious orange flames rising from patches of otherwise fairly inactive lava flows. This does not represent lava filling in gaps by flowing underneath the top of the lava field, but rather represents the ignition and burning of hydrogen gas. While hydrogen in pure form burns as a blue color, natural impurities in the air will generally cause it to burn with an orange coloration, hence what you are seeing. I suspect that over the next 24 hours that the lava field will expand slightly in the sector I have labeled on screen. While this could again cause the southernmost lava lobe to eventually start advancing again, this is unlikely until the two lobes of material merge. I also have a suggestion as for why explosive phreatic magmatic activity occurred on May 29th. So far, in all 5 eruptions of the Reykjanes volcano, only once has a fissure erupted directly through a raised subglacial feature. These features contain hyaloclastite and thus more groundwater, which is why there is more vegetation on them than on the surrounding lower rocks. I thus suggest that any time a fissure in the Reykjanes volcano ends up erupting right through a raised subglacial volcanic mound or hill, that limited phreatomagmatic explosive activity will follow. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Rob for supporting this channel.